Welcome to Dissima Architecture. My name is Andrea, and I'm here with Phil from Inawisdom. Hi, Phil. Welcome to the show.
Hi.
What do you guys do?
So we develop AI and ML solutions for our clients.
Great. So today we're here to talk about your IDP platform, which is Intelligent Document Processing. Tell our viewers, what is that?
So it allows insurance companies to understand what's inside policy documents so they know it's there and they can use it in their business.
Let's dive straight into the architecture. Assume that I am a company requesting a quote. So talk us through the flow from the intake stage.
Yeah, so the first bit is the pre-processing, and a Lambda kicks that off by going to the inbox and getting the email and all the attachments.
Okay.
And then puts that into S3.
I see. And what different types of intake attachments do you get?
Typically they're PDF, Word file, Excel, that kind of thing, but we can do more if needed.
Okay, so that's the first stage. Walk us through the logic. I do see AIML in the middle. Where does that come into the context of the use case?
So the next stage is kicked off by the Lambda, and it starts a step function.
Okay.
And then based on what kind of document it is, what line of business it is, it will use either Textract or custom model to work at extract the text from the document.
And what order do you use these?
So most of the time we'll be using Textract, and we'll use a custom model for very specific, like if it's very specific form data and a very specific format, we can highly tune a model to that exact.
I see. And where do you take the information from, and then where do you put it in?
So everything works around S3. So Textract will load those documents from S3. Do what it needs to do, and it will output its results to S3.
I see. And does it work the same way with your custom model in SageMaker?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Data goes in, model runs, and then the results come back out and stored back to S3.
I see. So for most cases, you can deal with the intake forms through Textract, but some custom intakes require that custom model for SageMaker. And then I do see Comprehend. Walk us through that. Where does that come in?
So we use that for classification, also named entity recognition. Basically, that allows us to work out if it's a person, if it's a location, organization, or a date. Again, it works in a similar format. It will load the files from S3, the results from the other stages, and then process it, and then put the results back into S3.
I see. So you have a pre-processing stage, I do see a step function, and then I assume this is the post-processing.
Yeah.
Walk us through that.
The heart of this is a Lambda again. So that Lambda will load the final results from all the different stages and work out what to do with it. So for example, Textract, when it has extracted a document, it will extract it per page at a time, but things like tables can span multiple pages. So in that Lambda, we're stitching that all back together to understand really the whole of that table and all the different values within it, for example. The other thing we're doing is looking for synonyms. Okay. So for example, the different styles of documents from different insurers will come through, and they'll have policy number, policy num, policy hash. They're all the same thing. Mm. We've got it here, but we still need to bring them all back together to that one data point. So that's what the synonym's about.
Okay. And where do you store that information?
So we store them in DynamoDB. Okay. So the Lambda will load that from DynamoDB.
I see. And so let's assume an intake comes in, and this is information you've never processed before. So you may not have the synonyms in the DynamoDB. How do you train that model?
So the first thing is we're monitoring in the process the accuracy, and if it's poor, we'll send it to SageMaker. Ground truth. What that means is we can then send it to a subject matter expert that can understand that document, label that document up to us, and we can retrain the models as needed, particularly this model, but you may do things with these two models. Also, we can put new synonyms into that database.
Okay, wonderful. So thank you, Phil, for walking us through this architecture where you're using the power of AIML to be able to extract information from the intake forms. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching Dissima Architecture.